All right, guys, kind of a long one today. This is going to be a small portion of a 2-hour address to a federal assembly that Putin gave back in March of 2018. In this address, he details multiple types of weapons that have been recently developed, tested. He shows some footage. I do have to say, I hold reservations about some of the legitimacy of the footage, and if you stick around, you'll probably see why. I think to some, this could be effectively argued as saber rattling, a type of showmanship. But with that out of the way, if you're interested in international news, what's going on in the geopolitical sphere, and what other countries are doing with their weapons, this video will be for you. Links in the description below to the full address and as well to the video I made addressing the simultaneous missile launches from China, Japan, Russia, and the United States. Thanks for checking me out.
After the United States withdrew from the ABM Treaty unilaterally, we've been working hard to create new promising weaponry systems, and this enabled us to make a big step forward, creating new strategic arms. U.S. global missile defense systems is mainly against ballistic missiles. And ballistic missiles, this is the core of our nuclear deterrent, just like with other nuclear powers. This is why Russia has been developing a very modest price-wise, but extremely effective systems to defeat missile defense, and all our ICBMs are equipped with such system now. Also, we have developed a new generation of missiles. Namely, currently, the Defense Ministry works together with defense companies in the space industry, and they're testing a new missile system that uses a heavy ICBM. We called it Sarmat. This new system will replace the old Voivode system that we had during the Soviet period. And Voivode was considered a highly effective weapon. Our foreign partners even used a different name for it. But Sarmat is a much more powerful system. With a payload of 200 tons, it is hard to be intercepted by missile defense capabilities. The range of this new missile and the number of warheads is higher than with Voivode. Sarmat will be equipped with the hypersonic high-yield systems with capabilities for beating missile defense systems. This new system can be used under any conditions. Let's now watch a video. Voivode had the range of 11,000 kilometers, and with Sarmat, with the new system, there is no range limitation. As you can see from this video, it can attack any target through the North Pole or through the via the South Pole. This is a powerful weapon, and no missile defense system will be able to withstand it. But even this is not at the end. We've developed the new strategic weapons that don't use ballistic trajectory at all, which means that missile defense will be useless against it. This is what I'm going to tell you about now. This new kind of weapon, promising weapon systems that Russia has developed using new, unique technology designed by our engineers. One of such systems is a small, super powerful nuclear energy system that can be deployed in a cruise missile like X-101, a Russian missile, or US-made Tomahawk missile, yet its range will be like 10 times higher, so, which means there is basically no limit to its range. It's a small missile with unlimited range and unpredictable trajectory that can avoid all intercept barriers, cannot be intercepted by existing or future missile defense systems. Late in 2017, at the central testing ground of the Russian Federation, we had a successful test launch of this newest cruise missile with the nuclear power energy unit, and it achieved proper altitude. So now, after the successful test, we can start manufacturing this new kind of weapon, a strategic nuclear weapon system with a missile carrying a nuclear power energy unit. Let's now watch this video. This is how it avoids defense barriers. It has unlimited range, so it can keep going like this forever, maneuvering. As you understand, this is unheard of, and nobody else has such a system in the world. They may create something similar in the future, but by that time our guys will come up with new ideas as well. Next, we all know that currently the whole world works actively on drones. We have unmanned submarines that move at ultra-deep levels intercontinentally with a speed that is much, much higher than the speed of modern submarines, torpedoes, and even the fastest surface ships. This is just fantastic. These vehicles are noiseless, and there is no defense system in the world today that can cope with such subsurface vehicles. They can be equipped with conventional or nuclear weapons, attacking coastal defenses and infrastructure facilities. In December 2017, we've completed testing this new innovative nuclear propulsion system for this unmanned subsurface vehicle. It's extremely small, and at the same time, its size is 100 times less than a regular submarine, and at the same time it's more powerful, and it takes 200 times less time to get to the launch site. This enabled us to develop new nuclear systems equipped with the new nuclear charges. Let's watch the next video now. By the way,
наименование этих двух новых
the names for these two new systems.
Стратегическое оружие России.
Of nuclear weaponry. The cruise missile, the global cruise missile, and this subsurface unmanned vehicle. We don't have the names for them yet, so you can send in your proposals to the website of the Defense Ministry.
Хорошо известно, что страна с высоким
научным потенциалом и that a country with a high level of science and economic development are working on hypersonic weapon systems.
Сверхзвуковая скорость измеряется
hypersonic speeds is measured in Machs, named after the Austrian scientist Ernst Mach. 1 Mach is 162 kilometers at the altitude of 11 kilometers. It's from 1 to 5 Machs, it's super sound. From above 5 Machs, it's hypersonic. These weapons are extremely powerful. Military experts say this is the future, and this makes it invulnerable. Interceptor missiles are not able to catch up with hypersonic missiles. This is why the world's leading armies want to have this weapon system. Friends, Russia now has such a weapon. We already have it. As we work on new systems, we've developed new hypersonic system, air-based system. I think you understand by now that nothing similar exists anywhere in the world. We've successfully tested this new system, and on December 1st, 2017, this system is already operational in the Southern Military District. It's on combat duty. Unique specifications of this new system will enable us to deliver the missile to its target in just a matter of a few minutes. This hypersonic missile that travels at the speed of more than 10 Mach can also maneuver, overcoming all the existing and, I think, even future air defense and missile defense systems, delivering its payload within the range of 2,000 kilometers with conventional and nuclear charges. We gave this system the name of Kinjal, dagger. Let's watch the next video now.
Но и это еще не все.
But even this is not the end.
Настоящим технологическим прорывом.
A real technology breakthrough. We've created a new missile strategic system that uses a fundamentally new equipment. It's a gliding block, cruise block. We've successfully tested this new system as well. We've repeatedly warned the U.S. and European NATO members that we will take steps to neutralize threats that arise from the deployment of their missile defense system. We said this publicly and in our bilateral talks in 2004, when for the first time ever we tested this system, which I'm going to describe now. Meeting with the media, I said, well, I don't feel good quoting myself, but it would be appropriate today. I said that as the military potential of our other countries grows qualitatively and quantitatively, Russia needs to have a new generation of weapons. So I'm pleased to inform you that after certain experiments we staged during these military exercises, which were successful, we are sure that soon Russia strategic new missile forces will have a new system capable of destroying intercontinental targets with hypersonic speed and high precision, able to maneuver in terms of both its course and altitude. Every word of what I just said is important. There are no such systems currently anywhere in the world. End of quote. And of course, every word here is important because we talked about missiles that are capable of bypassing, avoiding defensive barriers. We made no secret of our plans. We spoke openly of what we were about to do. We wanted to motivate our counterparts. This was in 2004, like I said, amazing, but despite of all the difficulties that we faced over the years, economic and financial problems, problems with our defense industry, with our armed forces, Russia remained a major nuclear power, but nobody wanted to talk to us seriously. They kept ignoring us. Nobody listened to us. So, listen to us now. Thank you. So, this system is different from other existing systems because it can go to dense strata of the atmosphere at hypersonic speeds at 20 Mach and more. This gliding cruise block is capable of deep maneuvers, lateral, several thousand kilometers, and also altitude-wise, which makes it completely invulnerable for any missile defense systems. It uses new composite materials, which resolves the problem of controlled long-range flight in plasma conditions. It goes like a meteorite towards its target, like a fireball. The temperature on the surface of this weapon reaches 2,000 degrees centigrade, and at the same time, it is still completely under control of the operator. Let's watch the video.
все. В силу понятных причин
for obvious reasons, we can't show you today what the actual system looks like.